The Mr. Men and Little Misses know the importance of taking care of their teeth. And that starts with regular brushing, faithful flossing, and last but not least, visiting the dentist twice a year. Of course, one way to good clean teeth is a reliable toothbrush. But with so many types of toothbrushes to choose from, picking the right one isn't easy. No, that one is too hard. What about this one? Bah, they have the nerve to call that a toothbrush? Mr. Rude! That is my name. Now go away. I am busy. You cannot put a brand new toothbrush into your mouth and then put it back on the shelf. It's unclean. How else am I supposed to know what toothbrush I want to buy? It doesn't work that way. You need to buy a toothbrush before you can try it. I have never heard of anything so ridiculous. Give me that! Mr. Rude, I am going to have to ask you to pay for all these toothbrushes you've used. Why should I pay for a toothbrush that I do not like? Because it's the rules. Let me see these rules. Well, it's not printed anywhere, but I assure you, this kind of behavior is unacceptable. I'll give you unacceptable.
Mr. Rude!
You leave me no choice but to call the store manager. Attention all personnel. The store manager is needed in the toothbrush aisle.
Hello, Mr. Rude. I'm the store manager.
And what do you want? A medal? Mr. Happy, I am sorry to inform you that Mr. Rude is putting brand new toothbrushes into his mouth and then returning them back to the shelf.
How wonderfully disgusting!
Yes, quite. Which is why I thought he should be removed immediately.
But, Mr. Fussy, here in my store, I want happy, happy customers.
But a filthy, used... Voila! I have finally found a toothbrush that I like. I am happy now. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Rude. Come again soon.
Store manager needed in the shampoo aisle.
Whoa, duty calls. I'll leave you to clean up this toothbrush display, Mr. Fussy.
How utterly revolting.
Hey, Mr. Fussy. I need a new toothbrush, but I don't know which one to buy. Can I try some out?
About all the terrible, horrible, scary things that can happen to your teeth if you don't take care of them. This is what happens when you eat too many sweets. Cavities! Holes in your teeth the size of moon craters! This is plaque. A yucky buildup of crud on your teeth. If you don't brush every day, plaque will grow into giant monsters and take over the planet! Wait a minute! What's so bad about gross cavities or oozing plaque monsters? That sounds fantastic! Find someone else to do this, I quit!
Pat? Can I get a new tooth fairy in here, please?
Boopity boop.
On the other side of town, Mr. Grumpy has settled in to watch one of his favorite TV shows. The last thing on his mind is his teeth.
When fishing for flounder, it's very important to keep your line perfectly still. Don't move a muscle.
Keep it down out there! Trying to watch Flounder Friday. Crooked cucumbers, what now?
Hiya, Mr. Grumpy!
Mr. Messy, Miss Sunshine.
We're not early, are we?
For what?
The meeting of our Clean Teeth Club. It's your turn to host.
But I quit this little club of yours months ago.
Oh, silly Mr. Grumpy. No one can quit the Clean Teeth Club. We're all lifetime members.
Look, I'm very busy right now. You're going to have to find somewhere else to meet.
Shazam! I want one of these!
Get out of my chair! Only I get to sit there. Oh, great. Miss Chatterbox and Mr. Tickle.
Hope we're not late. We got to tickling and lost all track of time. We also got a little lost on the way here, but that is a completely other story.
Actually, we were just about to begin the Clean Teeth Club oath.
Is there time for a quick tickle?
Not if you value those arms.
I promise to love my teeth and clean them well. At regular flossing, I will excel.
I'll always brush 3 times a day and celebrate the clean teeth way. Well, that was a fascinating meeting. We'll have to do it again sometime. Time for you to go.
But we're just getting started. I haven't even given out the Clean Teeth Club gift of the week.
A gift? Why didn't you say so?
Today, all members of the Clean Teeth Club get their very own electric toothbrush.
You call that a gift?
Normally, I'm not big on cleaning. But I make an exception when it comes to teeth.
Oh, good for you, Mr. Messy. Now give it a try.
Sorry, Mr. G.
Crooked cucumbers.
Are you sure you don't want to tickle?
Positive.
Now make sure you brush all your teeth, especially the ones in the back.
Does it get any better than this?
I could do this all day, though I suppose I'd have to stop if I wanted to eat anything or needed to use both my hands for something.
Like give a tickle?
No!
My television! It's ruined!
Maybe all it needs is a tickle.
How about we sing the Clean Teeth Club song?
Scrub, 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 we're the Clean Teeth Club, and we brush in for a while.
Now in a round!
Okay.
Brush, brush, brush all the plaque away, put a sparkle in your slime.
That's it! I can put up with you invading my home and destroying my television, but I will not listen to your cockamamie song. I quit this club! Again! Wait a minute. This is my house. You people leave.
Whatever you say, Mr. Grumpy. Thanks so much for hosting us.
Sorry again about the television, Mr. Grumpy.
One more tickle for the road?
Don't even.
Let me know if you ever want to get rid of that chair.
Dream on. No! Ha! Ha! No! Ha! Ha! No!
Mr. Quiet always enjoys having his teeth cleaned. Did I say always? I meant usually.
There you go, Mr. Quiet. The dentist will be in shortly. Make yourself comfortable.
Will do, Mr. Small.
Hello, Mr. Quiet. Wow, I see here on your chart that it's been 9 months since your last cleaning.
Yeah, I lost track. Time flies.
Ah, there you are, Mr. Nosy. The dentist is ready to see you now.
You're, not a dentist?
Mr. Quiet, your dentist will be right in.
Whoops. Hello, Mr. Quiet. Looks like we're gonna be cleaning your teeth.
You know, on second thought, maybe I should just come back another day, you know?
Don't worry. I'm a trained professional. Today we're gonna use a water jet to do the cleaning. It can get a little wet. That's why we have these handy smocks.
Oh, fancy.
This tiny stream of water is powerful enough to wash away any plaque from your teeth. Now open wide.
Oh, okay.
Well, I guess we're done with that part. Now let's polish those teeth of yours.
Oh, I like this part.
Let's just add the polish. It's supposed to be pineapple flavored, but I think it tastes like salt. Oh, well. At least you'll have the best smile in Dilly Dell. Let's let the suction hose get rid of some of that foam for you. Where did I put the polisher? I don't know why I can't remember where I put things. What? Must have hit the wrong switch. You did great, Mr. Quiet. Don't forget to come back in 6 months for your next cleaning.
So you see, the good people of Dillydale take clean teeth very seriously. They brush, they floss. Why, there's no end to the ways the Mr. Men and Little Misses celebrate clean teeth. Even if some of those ways are a little scary.